now we will start AC through pure resistive circuit. Pure resistive circuit. So here this is the circuit. We have taken only one resistance. This is the AC source. The voltage is the same one, that is V is equal to Vm sin omega t. This is a resistive load and the voltage drop that we have taken, suppose it is Vr. The current flowing through the circuit is I. So here Vr we can write down I into R. Here the circuit current is I and Vr means voltage drop across the resistor. Okay, then according to Ohm's law, V is equal to I into R, we know. And in this circuit, we are having only one resistance, means this Vr is equal to this V. Means I can write down this Vr is equal to this V, that is equal to I into R. And we can also write down, because V is equal to what? Vm sin omega t. So I can write down here the value of I. The value of I is equal to what? That is V by R. Or in this place, I can write down the value of I. I is equal to what? That is Im sin omega t. Where the value of this Im is Vm by R, maximum value of voltage by the circuit resistance. This is according to Ohm's law. Im is equal to Vm by R. So I is equal to Im sin omega t. And here V is equal to Vm sin omega t. So that's why if we will draw the waveform, so it should be in phase, isn't it? This is V, which is equal to Vm sin omega t. And we got I is equal to also Im sin omega t. So this one, this is I. Both are the in phase components. I is equal to Im sin omega t. And if we will draw the phasor diagram, phi is equal to 0. This is the concept of a purely resistive circuit. In this circuit, voltage and current are in phase and phase angle is 0. If phase angle is 0, we have one term, that is power factor. It should be cos phi. So cos of 0 is equal to 1. So in case of a purely resistive circuit, the value of power factor is unity or 1. Again, if we will find the value of power at any instant or instantaneous power. So we know the value of power is equal to V into I, simply voltage into current. The value of V is equal to Vm sin omega t, I is equal to Im sin omega t. So it should be Vm Im sin square omega t. Then we are writing this sin square omega t as 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. So it should be, or it should have two components. P is equal to Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2 cos 2 omega t. This is the value of power at any instant or instantaneous power. Then if you will go for the average power, so we have to take this average power for a complete cycle. So complete cycle means our limit must be 0 to 2 pi and it should be 1 by 2 pi. And we have to integrate it with d omega t. So obviously this term will become 0. Your cos 2 omega t and d omega t. This will be 0. So power must be P is equal to simply Vm Im by 2. Then this Vm Im by 2 I can write on Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2. So Vm by root 2 means Vrms. Im by root 2 means Irms. So it is simply P is equal to Vrms into Irms, or simply V into I in case of resistive load. Okay. So now in this case we can conclude that in case of a resistive circuit, I and V both are in phase. Im is equal to Vm by R. P is equal to V into I. Now let's do a problem. In the circuit, it is given that a pure resistance of 10 ohm is given, having a supply voltage of 230 volt and 50 hertz. Voltage, resistance, and frequency is given. Calculate current, power consumed, equation of voltage and current. So let's do the problem. So data given here is data given. The value of resistance R is equal to 10 ohm, V is equal to 230 volt, and frequency F is equal to 50 hertz. And we need to find out the circuit current first. So for finding out circuit current, what we need, simply apply Ohm's law. That means this is V by R. So V is given 230, R is given 10. So simply the answer is 23 ampere. Unit of current is ampere. This is the answer for first bit. Then in the second bit, we need to find out the power consumed of the circuit. So P is equal to, now we have seen P is equal to simply voltage into current, V into I. So the value of V is equal to 230, I is equal to 23. So it should be 5260 watt. This is the answer for the second bit. Then in the third bit, we need to find out the equation of voltage and current. So for finding out equation of voltage and current, we know that V is equal to what? Vm sine omega t, and I is equal to Im sine omega t. These are the equations of voltage and current. So for writing down the equations, we need to find out Vm, Im, and the value of omega. Then we can write down the values of our equation for V and I. So now the value of Vm will be how much? The voltage given in the circuit, in the question, that is Vrms. So it should be Vm is equal to root 2 into Vrms. This is the value. And here the Vrms value is equal to 230 volt. It should be root 2 into 230. The value must be 325.27 volt. This is the value of Vm. Then if we find out the value of Im, same one, root 2 into Irms. So here root 2 into the value of I is 23. So it should be 32.52 ampere. Again, the value of omega. Omega is equal to 2 pi f. So 2 pi into f is given 50 hertz. So it should be 50. So it is 314 radian per second. Unit of omega or angular frequency is radian per second. So now we have Vm, we have Im, and we have omega. So we can write down the values. The value of V is equal to, it should be Vm means 325.27 sine omega means 314 T, and value of I is equal to 32.52. Then sine omega is 314 T. This is the answer for V and I. Okay, so next we will study about AC through pure inductive circuit. This is the circuit, AC through pure inductive circuit. So here we can see that we are having only inductance in the circuit. We are having only inductance, and here we will see, or we have to find out the value of voltage and current or what is the relation of voltage with current. So here we can write down V is equal to same thing Vm sin omega t, and that is also equal to VL. VL is what? Voltage drop across this inductor. And also we know that we have one formula, V is equal to L di by dt for an inductor. So that means this Vm sin omega t and this VL or L di by dt, both are equal. If both are equal, then the value of di is equal to Vm by L sin omega t, and value of I we need to find out. That means I is equal to Vm by L sin omega t dt. We are integrating that part. So now sin become cos, it should be Vm by omega L sin, it is minus cos omega t, it should be sin omega t minus pi by 2. So I is equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. We have to write down the equation of this I in terms of that sine wave. So we have to convert this cos into sin, then it should be Im. Im is equal to what here? This term, that is Vm by omega L, that is equal to Im. So here we can conclude that if V is equal to Vm sin omega t, I must be is equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. Now let's draw the circuit. That means the same thing I am drawing here. This is inductor, this is the voltage source V. Inductor voltage across this is known as VL, and this is the circuit current. We know that V is equal to Vm sin omega t, and we found there I is equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. Omega t minus pi by 2. And this term Im is equal to XL. It is equal to omega L, or omega value is 2 pi f. It should be 2 pi f L. This XL is known as inductive reactance. Inductive reactance of the circuit, and its unit is ohm, same as resistance in DC circuit. Means this reactance will oppose the flow of current as like resistance do. The unit is ohm, that is known as XL. So here we found out the value of Im, sorry, it is Im. Maximum current is equal to maximum voltage by this inductive reactance. And so if we got the value of V and I can draw the waveform. So the waveform must be V is equal to Vm sin omega t. V is always our reference. This is V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Then this point is pi by 2. This is 0, this is pi. So here the value of I is equal to what? Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. So from this, I will start from this point. This is, the waveform is I is equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. So here the phase angle between voltage and current, phi is equal to what? Pi by 2 or 90 degree. In a purely inductive circuit, the phase angle between voltage and current is 90 degree. So if we will draw this is the waveform, and if we will draw the phasor diagram, I am taking voltage as the reference. If voltage is the reference, current must be lagging by an angle 90 degree, because 90 degree is the value of phi here. Here this is phasor diagram of a purely inductive circuit where the value of phi is 90 degree. Here I can conclude that in purely inductive circuit, I lags V by an angle 90 degree. So therefore, the value of cos phi or power factor, cos 90 is what? It is 0. So value of power factor in purely inductive circuit is 0. This is the conclusion here. So let's do one problem here. We will have to see the value of power. Again the same thing, the value of instantaneous power is P is equal to same thing, that is V into I. The value of V is Vm sin omega t, I is Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. So now again we have to simplify this one. So it should be P is equal to minus Vm Im by 2 sin 2 omega t, because here we are having sin omega t into cos omega t. We are converting it into sin 2 omega t by 2. Again, if we will find out the average power, so obviously the same thing we will repeat, means we have to take the power over one cycle. So the limit must be 0 to 2 pi. So here we can see it is sin 2 omega t d omega t. So it should be 0. So here we can conclude that the average power for a purely inductive circuit must be 0. Okay. Now do one problem here. A pure inductive coil allows an alternating current of 10 ampere, current is given 10 ampere, to flow from 230 volt 50 hertz supply. Current, voltage and frequency is given. Calculate inductance of the coil, power observed, and again equation of V and I. So here again I am writing down the data given. What are the data given here? The value of current I is given. I is equal to 10 ampere, then voltage is given, that is 230 volt, then frequency is also given, that is 50 hertz. These are the data given. Okay, and we need to find out the inductance of the coil. So for finding out the inductance of the coil, first of all I have to find out XL, because the value of I is equal to V by XL. So I is given, V is given, I can find out XL. Once I find out XL, XL is equal to what? 2 pi FL. So I can find out L. This is the procedure. So now, first of all, the value of XL, XL, it is equal to 2 pi FL. 2 pi FL. Or this must be is equal to, XL is equal to V by I. V by I. So V is given, that is 230. I is given 10. So XL is equal to 23 ohm. There is a value of XL. But I need to find out L. So the value of L must be what? It should be XL divided by 2 pi F. So the value of XL is equal to 23, it is 2 pi into 50. So now the value of L is equal to 0.073 Henry. The unit of inductance is Henry. This is the answer of the first bit. Then second bit, power absorbed by a circuit. So now we have seen that the average power of a purely inductive circuit is what? It is simply 0. So this is the answer for the second bit. Power absorbed is 0. Then in the third bit, equation of V and I. So let's go for the same procedure. V is equal to what? Vm. So find out Vm and Im. The value of Vm, it must be root 2 into Vrms. So here it is root 2 into V is equal to 230. The value of this V is equal to 325.25 volt. Value of Im is equal to root 2 into 10. So it should be 14.14 ampere. Then value of omega is equal to 2 pi f. So it should be 2 pi into 50.
that is 314 radian per second.
So we are putting all this value in that equation. That means the value of V is equal to Vm is equal to 325.25 Vm sin omega means 314 t, and value of Im is equal to 14.14 sin 314 sin omega t minus pi by 2.
Thank you.